Hey guys, it's Eb, and yes, we're gonna be playing some Dark Souls. Just recently got a Hopog HD PVR, and yeah, so this is all gonna be 360 footage. It's about time. It's been a long time coming. I should have done it way back when I had Battlefield 2 Bad Company and we were just wrecking house back then. That would have just been such a good time, but I have it now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna play some Dark Souls. I don't know exactly how I'm going to do the episodes. I was thinking just maybe doing episodics, maybe just helps, hints, and how to kill bosses, and also where things are. Because I only have a 12 minute to 13, 14 minute time frame on YouTube, which kind of sucks. If I had a half an hour time frame, or an hour plus, you know what, I might just do full playthrough. But it just takes too much time to edit 15 minute to 12 minute videos, so... Yeah, so anyway, we're gonna go here and I'm gonna create a knight, warrior here, and I already have other characters, but I want to show you from the beginning, for anybody else who hasn't started it, or, you know, just to get everybody into it. So, I'm gonna go ahead here and make a check, because all my main characters are guys, so let's try to do a little something different here. I've already messed around with the character customization, so I'm gonna be pretty quick here. Yeah, red's good. But yeah, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna skip the intro. I'm gonna put the intro separate, so you guys go watch the intro as its own thing. I'm gonna go right into the game. Do the first 12-15 minutes of the beginning. I'm not gonna touch any of the tutorial stuff, because you know you can do that on your own. But I'm just gonna show you quick and simple, easy way to get through and to defeat the demon boss on the other side, because yeah, there's a little trick to the first part of that, and yeah. So anyway, we're in Northern Undead Asylum. Now, really got to it's really hard in this game. Ugh, I'm ugly. It's really hard in this game to really remember exactly where you are, because there's so many different places and so many different names, and basically wherever you want to go, you can go if you can actually kill the enemies in there. Wherever you go, I'm just gonna kill this guy real quick. Heavy attacks, slices and dices, and yeah. Anyways, you start off with a sword hilt, and it's pretty useless. And yeah, I know you're looking at that guy, and you're like, "Whoa, that's badass." Well, guess what? You get to fight that later. Not now, but later. We'll get to that later in another episode. So, anyways, let's just head down here. I'm not gonna be killing everything I see, because it's kind of pointless. It's just fun if you want to like practice your swords or your hilt attacks. Cause yeah. Anyway, the game is gorgeous. The only thing I have to report is that yes, it is true that the game does lag and lose frames in certain areas of the game for unknown reasons. Really, maybe it's just the vast expanse of the level itself. But yeah, I don't know. It's still not a problem for me. It's a problem for everybody else. Who cares? I'm fairly confident the PS3 version also has frame rate issues, because it just doesn't make sense why the Xbox would be the only thing. So anyway, that's a bonfire. And yeah, you sit at the bonfire and you can gain health back and save and do all your good stuff. So anyway. So here's our first encounter. Oh, he is ugly. Now very quickly run to the left here. And there's a door. And the count is over, because there's no way you can defeat him without a sword. So you're just gonna light all these bonfires. Sitting at bonfires allows you to get level up, repair items, reinforce items, and also upgrade certain items such as shields, swords, armor. This will all be explained. I'll explain this all later once we get to the vendor, so I can show you the items you're actually going to be buying with your souls that you collect. So anyway, this little skeleton here, he's a little bastard, shoots you because he knows you don't have a sword. And there's your first sword, long sword. So you just quickly go through the menus. You'll get used to the menus. Menus are a little annoying at first, pressing the buttons and escaping and unequipping stuff, but, you gotta watch out for the guys with the arrows, because you might think they're shooting straight, but the arrows have a slight homing ability. Finish her right there. They have a slight homing ability. They will track you if you stand, if you move to the left and stand there, you will get still hit. You will still get hit by it. It's nasty. It's really nasty. But it's just the way it is. Otherwise, they would never hit you with anything because that would be too easy. And right up here, there's a boulder, so you want to jump. Otherwise, you'll get. It's okay. I'm sure you'll all get squashed once.
Oh, you. You're no Hollow. Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon, then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we're both undead. Hear me out, will you? Regrettably, I have failed in my mission. But perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen. And thine exodus from the undead asylum maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords. When thou ringeth the bell of awakening, the fate of the undead thou shalt know. Well, now you know. And I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask. An undead favorite. Oh, and this. Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now. And thank you.
I really want your armor.
Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you, and thank you.
You can counter these guys as well. I don't know why I didn't finish that there, because when you counter them, it's an instant. If you press RB on your controller, it's usually an instant finishing move right there. That didn't work for some reason. I don't know. Maybe it's the angle. I'll try to do it again, but these undead here are the most unpredictable. I find they're still super hard to get the timing right. Sometimes it's just not worth it. Maybe I'll try now. Ah, see? There you go. So that's pretty much that's what you can expect. It's just brutal and awesome. One power attack does it. So yeah, if I can say anything, get your timing down, because it'll make your world a lot easier. And this is locked. You can open that later, but not now. So don't even worry about it. Don't even think about it. Okay, now this is tricky. All you're gonna do is when you go here, continuously tap RB, and you can do a downward attack. I mean, half his health gone is pretty good in my books. Let's wait for him to do the drop. We'll run in and get a quick hit. Yep, get a quick hit. Now, one thing I'm going to tell you guys about Dark Souls, and I'm sure everybody who's played Demon Souls will know, do not get greedy with your attacks. The minute you get greedy and you try to hit them too much, you will probably die. You should got to remember, your stamina is also your block, your stamina is also your dodge, and your stamina is also your hit, so don't be greedy. Go in and be precise. So as you can see, as long as you basically, best bet is to get around behind him, but if he's facing the wall like that, to coax him out is a little bit hard. And then he goes and does that, which he hasn't done the entire time we've had this fight, which is awesome. Bosses and enemies can be so unpredictable, because they may not ever do one attack the entire time you fight them, and then all of a sudden they do it. And you're like, where did that come from? And he's dead. We got the big pilgrim's key. And we can pretty much get out of here now. And you can still hear the other one walking. Because he's still in the dungeon. Mm. And there's two things I want to show you here before we leave. Because I didn't know this, obviously, in the beginning.
You... Give me warm. Give me soft.
So anyway, she is an invisible vendor who was originally in Dark Souls. And she's in this game now, too. I can't remember her name. Something Bird Girl or something like that. Anyway, if you drop things into the nest, certain items, she will convert those items into other items. I may give you a full list of those items later on, so you guys don't have to go and buy a guide and all that stuff. So, anyways, a little secret here. Soul of the Lost Undead. Basically, you use souls of the Lost Undead. Whenever you get them off like a corpse like that, you can use them and you can basically just get souls out of them for leveling up and all the rest.
Only in the ancient legends it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen. To leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage to the land of the ancient lords. Lordran.
Okay, so yeah. Okay, everyone, this is where we're going to cut it short. I will bring you more episodes coming soon.